Hey there, welcome to this tutorial on DaVinci Resolve, a professional video editing software for Windows, macOS, and Linux completely free to use with no watermarks. This is Zach, and I will be your guide to cover all the basics you need to start using the free version of this software in a few minutes. Please consider that most of the newest AI tools are available only in the paid studio version. When you open Resolve, the Project Manager shows up, with all your existing projects from your local computer or your Blackmagic Design Cloud. To start from scratch, click on New Project in the bottom right corner. You can always return to the Project Manager with the Home button. The main interface is divided into several workspaces listed on the bottom. With Media, you manage your source files. With Cut, you trim these. With Edit, you build your own video. With Fusion, you realize advanced visual effects. With Color, you apply color correction and grading. With Fairlight, you edit audio and apply sound effects. With Deliver, you render and export your final video. In this tutorial, we will see the most important workspaces you need to get started. To import videos, audio, and images, open the Edit workspace and drag and drop these files from any folder into the Media Pull panel on the left. From here, you can also hover over any source to preview its content. At this point, drag and drop any file onto the timeline to start working. You can hide any panel you do not need by clicking on its name. Each file is an independent clip, with visual ones placed on video tracks in blue color and sound ones on audio tracks, shown in green. To record with your microphone, right-click on the left side and create a new track. Go to VoiceOver on top and give a file name to the new clip, Fixing Audio Input and Destination Track. Click on the Record button to start recording, clicking again to finish. To manage the timeline content, go to Timeline View options on the left. Here, resize or hide the clip thumbnails or audio waveforms, and adjust the track height as you need. Zoom in and out on the content by holding the Alt key while using the mouse wheel, and scroll through time by holding Control or Command. To check the timeline content, take a look at the video preview above. Use its player to play back the project in real time, or place the red marker in time to check specific frames. You can adjust the preview options from project settings in the bottom right corner, such as the video resolution on timeline format and frame rate. Make sure to save your project often with Control or Command and S. If you do not save for a long time, a red edited label will appear at the top as a reminder. Now, let's see how to edit clips in selection mode. Click and drag any clip to move it in time, within the same track, or across different tracks. When a video clip has audio, they move together unless you unlink them by right-clicking and going to Link Clips. When clips overlap on different tracks, the clip on the top track will be shown in front of other clips. If clips overlap within the same track, part of the content is trimmed. Make sure to use Control or Command and Z to undo any action if you make a mistake. Drag the clip edges to trim its content. You can also right-click on the clip to choose Change Clip Speed to speed up or slow down by adjusting the percentage above or below 100% without cutting any of the content. You can also reverse the clip or correct its audio pitch through this menu. If the clip is deeply slowed down, you can open the Inspector panel on the right and head to Video, Retime and Scaling to improve the slow motion effect by selecting Optical Flow as Process. You can also make quick copies of a clip by holding down the Alt key while dragging it in time. To remove a clip, select it and press the backspace key. To split it, enable Blade Edit Mode and click on the clip where you need. On the left, you get several options to control the content of each track. You can lock a track to block any further modification to its clips. You can use the Frame button to hide or show its visual content, the M button to mute any audio track, and the S button to solo it. To remove an entire track, right-click on it and select Delete Track. In the top right corner, open the Inspector panel to adjust the properties for the selected clip, divided into sections that vary depending on the clip type. For video clips and images, the Video section shows the transform options to move, scale, and rotate your clip. You can either use the sliders or enter specific values that you apply with the Enter key. You can also use the Revert button to reset any property and the orange button to turn modifications on or off. Make sure that the playhead is on the selected clip you are editing, or you won't see anything changing. To quickly adapt the clip to the project settings, head to Retime and Scaling, and select the best option as scaling to correct it on the go. You may turn off this effect if you want to transform the clip precisely. Use Pitch and Yaw to 3D rotate, or flip horizontally or vertically. On cropping, crop the clip as you need, adding feather with softness, and switch to Dynamic Zoom to apply motion effects, as we will see shortly. On Composite, adjust the clip opacity and blend modes. On Stabilization, reduce shakiness from videos, and on Lens Correction, adjust any distortion coming from camera lens. On the left, you get these options as tools, such as Transform, Cropping, and Dynamic Zoom. When enabling Transform, you can click and drag on the preview to move the clip, or use its nodes to scale and rotate. If you don't see these nodes, make sure the Transform tool is on. When enabling Dynamic Zoom, you get two colored rectangles, a green one representing the starting point, and a red one representing the end. By editing these rectangles, you define the motion path from the start to the end rectangle. When selecting audio clips, the Inspector panel shows options to adjust volume, balance the stereo channels, or even auto-adjust the volume from different sources within the clip with AI dialogue. You can also correct the pitch and apply audio filters with Equalizer. When selecting raw images, the Image section lists several properties to adjust colors and correct the photo appearance. Now, let's see how to edit properties in time. Select the intersected clip and open the Keyframes panel on top, showing all the properties you can edit in time, grouped by type. Switch to Keyframe Curves on the left to get the same properties as Envelopes in time, shown or hidden according to the params list above. At this point, place the marker in the correct instant of time, and click on the envelope while holding down the Alt or Option key to save the property value there through a keyframe. You can do the same in other instances, and drag the points as you need, horizontally to move in time, and vertically to edit the property value. You can select any keyframe to add curves on top. Remove any selected keyframe with Control or Command and X, or remove all with the Revert button and the parameters list. Let's see how to add effects, transitions, and titles with the Effects panel on the left. On Toolbox, Effects, browse through several effects designed in the Fusion workspace, as well as professional visual effects under Open Effects, and audio effects under Audio Effects. Hover over any effect to get a quick preview of it, and drag and drop it onto the clip to apply it. This clip gets an FX icon, and also a new effects section on the Inspector panel, where you can fine-tune the effects properties as you like. You can also change the effect's order with the arrows, or remove it completely with the bin button. On Toolbox, Transitions, you can browse for several video and audio transitions you can apply. Just drag and drop any onto the edge of a clip, or between two consecutive clips placed next to each other. You can manage the transition just like a clip that you can select and modify through the inspector panel. You can drag its edges to change its duration. For example, a shorter transition is also faster in time. To remove any transition, select it and use the backspace key. To add text, go to Toolbox, Titles. Drag and drop any text template onto the timeline, creating a gray text clip that you can edit as other clips on the timeline. It is important that the text clip is placed on the top video track in order to keep it visible and not overlapped by other visual clips. As you select the text clip, you can open the inspector panel to edit its content, font, style, size, color, and animation. Switch to the Settings tab to adjust the standard video options instead. To export your video, switch to the Deliver workspace. On the timeline, set the Gray In-Out region, defining the part of the project to export. On the left, open the Render Settings panel to select the video template to use. Choose Custom Export to configure your own setup on video codec, format, resolution, frame rate, data rate, and bit depth. You can also choose H.264 for MP4 videos or ready templates for YouTube, Vimeo, or TikTok. Choose Audio Only to export audio in MP3. On the chosen template, select File Name and Destination Folder. More below, select Single Clip to export what you have selected on the timeline under the In-Out region. Select Individual Clips to export the single clip selected from the list above the timeline. As you finish the setup, click on Add to Render Queue at the bottom to transfer your setup into the Render Queue panel on the right. Here, select the job you want to export and click Render to process it as a final video file. Thank you for watching this tutorial on DaVinci Resolve. For more tips and tricks on video production, be sure to visit our YouTube channel and official website where you can access loads of free resources and tutorials.